Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. Today we will have our 80th lesson, day number 80. In the series of our vocabulary lessons, from 1 through 100, the 80th lesson, as I said. Let's get going, shall we? The very first word we have here, the next three or four words that we have here, 1, 2, 3, 4, about five words we're going to have next, the first five words in a row that we're going to learn, they all basically mean the same thing. Let's begin. What is it? What does this word esoteric mean? Esoteric. It's an adjective. What does it mean when you describe something as being esoteric? If you tell me that his comment was esoteric, or this book is esoteric, or his lecture was esoteric, what does it mean? It just means it was difficult to understand. Understood by only a few. His lecture was esoteric. In other words, only a few people understood it. The rest of the people in the audience found it very difficult to follow him, found it very difficult to understand what he was talking about, what he was arguing. Very difficult to follow his argument. Something that is difficult to understand. Something that is difficult to understand. Something that is difficult to understand is described as being esoteric. Listen to another word. Recondite. Again, an adjective. It just means not easily understood. Not easily understood. So in that sense, they're synonym. If something is described as being recondite, it's not easily understood, it's difficult to follow, it's difficult to comprehend, it's understood only by a few, it's very esoteric. It is abstruse. Abstruse. Which means all again the same thing. Difficult to understand, difficult to follow. Recondite, esoteric, abstruse. Let's move on. I need to fit in two more words. Had I not been so liberal in my usage of this space, we could have fit two more words here, but there is no room here, so we're going to have to erase something. So that's it, we're done. Esoteric, recondite, and abstruse. Let's learn two more words, which will basically mean the same thing. They are all related, you understand? Cryptic. Which means difficult to understand. Difficult to understand. Something that is mystifying. Something that is mystifying. It's cryptic. It is enigmatic. It is enigmatic. Let's learn the word enigma. Enigma. Notice the last syllable is m, not ma. is not enigma, enigma. What is an enigma? Enigma is something that is difficult to understand, something that is puzzling. Something that is puzzling. The word puzzling comes from the puzzle. Something that is puzzling. Something that is ambiguous. Something that is ambiguous. Something whose meaning is not clear. Something that is difficult to understand. Something that is difficult to understand is an enigma. It is enigmatic. Right here, it is enigmatic. Enigmatic is the adjective. It is enigmatic, it is cryptic, it is esoteric. I find it recondite, I find it abstruse. I can't understand it. I cannot understand it. That's it. Those were the four or five words having to do with difficulty to understand something. Having difficulty to understand something. The next two or three words we're going to learn, maybe four words, they're all animals. Let's learn them, shall we? So now, animals. I have four of them. The very first one. Crow. Of course, you know what a crow is. Crow is a crow, it's a bird, it's a black bird. Why are we covering it? Why is this a vocabulary word? Well, it's a vocabulary word if you use it as a verb. What does it mean to crow? As a noun, it's a bird, of course, it flies, it's a black bird. If you're crowing, that means you're bragging. It means to brag, to show off, to show off. Stop crowing, okay? I know you got a new necklace. I know you have a new necklace. Stop crowing. Stop showing off. Stop bragging about it. It means to boast. To boast. To crow. Let's learn one more, shall we? The next word we're going to learn is a cow. And of course, you know what a cow is. Cow as in moo, of course. But what does it mean when you use this word as a verb? What does it mean to cow? The past tense of to cow would be just like any other regular verb, cowed. He cowed. He's cowing. He is cowing. What does it mean to cow? To cow means to frighten someone. To frighten someone. To scare someone. To scare someone. To scare someone, to frighten someone with threats or show of force. With threat or show of force. Yes, I know. I know the judge did not rule the way we expected. I know that the judge did not rule the way most people expected him to rule. Because he was cowed. Because he was cowed. He has received many threats. He has received many threats. He was scared for his life. And he did not want to rule the way it should have been ruled, because he was, the judge in the trial was, he was cowed. He was threatened, he was frightened, he was scared for his life. He was scared, he was threatened. Let's move on, shall we? The next word we're going to learn is dog. And of course you know what that is. What does it mean, to dog? Past tense would be dogged. Dogged. He dogged me. He's dogging me. This thing is dogging me. If something dogs you, it means it is a constant source of annoyance. Something that is a constant source of annoyance. Something that is a constant source of nuisance. If you find something that is annoying, that is a nuisance, that is bothersome, you say, my God, that thing has dogged me for 5 years. It has annoyed me, it has bothered me, it has nagged me for 5 years. It's been dogging me. To dog. A constant source of annoyance, constant source of nuisance, constant source of irritation, a constant source of bother. I did this years ago, about 10 some years ago. I did this and this to this person. I feel bad about it, and ever since that it had dogged me. Finally, I met the person the other day. I made a clean breast of it. We learned that expression yesterday. I made a clean breast of it. I admitted everything to all my wrongdoing. I apologized, and the person was generous enough, the person was gracious enough to forgive me. I'm glad that he forgave me, because it had dogged me all these years. To dog. Let's move on, shall we? I need a break. Let's learn one more word. And the word is badger. Badger. Notice badger has a silent D. Badger has a silent D. One does not pronounce the D. Badger. It's an animal. Of course. But what does it mean to badger as a noun? Badger means to annoy. To irritate. To pester. To bother. Stop bothering your sister. Stop annoying her. Stop pestering her. Stop annoying her. Stop irritating her. Do not badger her. Leave her alone. Leave her in peace. Don't badger her. Don't annoy her. Don't irritate her. She doesn't like it. Stop badgering her. Bye now.